In this video, I am going to show you how to design your academy's look and feel. But before I start explaining the functionalities, let me tell you that thousands of designs could fashion a website or app, and there is no way a service like us could give all these options to the user to do it themselves professionally. Therefore, we give the liberty to tell us what look and feel it should be. That is the design you would like your online academy to have, and we will make it the way in a short period without charging anything for this service. Nevertheless, you can design the academy in the template which you get by default. This template is optimal for an online academy, and hundreds of our clients do like it.
Before we go to see how to do the customization, let me show you the default academy.
You can have information blocks which can have text and or multimedia, some courses, testimonials, and you can adjust their position as well.
Then down below you can ask for people to subscribe to your newsletter, and you can have your social icons here as well. Then you have the About Us page, whose snippet can be shown on the home page also. You can have the testimonial as well here on About Us page. Further,
you can have page of courses.
Here the course categories will be visible, not the courses per se, but the categories in which all the courses are organized will be visible here. Then Contact Us page. Then Blogs. You can put n number of blogs,
and for the sake of demonstration, one demo blog is visible here. Further, along with these standard pages, you can have infinite number of other pages with the names of your choosing. We have also put a sample terms of use page with generic terms, privacy and cookies policy. And on this page, even if you decide to keep the exact text, you need to put the correct domain name and name of the entity. You can customize the page as per your policies and legal requirements.
Now all these pages can be customized. You can put many more pages here, infinite number of pages here.
And by default, any new pages made will be visible in the submenu of the link named More. Or we can put it anywhere on the site as per the suitability of the design and template adopted or your preference. Now we have customized lot of our academies as per our clients' demands. And for the sake of demonstration, let me show you two such academies built on our platform. This is one such academy.
The URL is digitalaiacademy.com, and it has got the landing page very different from the default one,
and the course landing page is also as per their bespoke design.
So everything can be customized here. You can see the Contact Us page. It's very straightforward, and it's very different from the default one.
Even the menu of the portal has been arranged as per the design template. Now let's see quickly the second academy created and running on our platform with a different design. They wanted to list their associated physical academies too, which can be browsed through this offline button, and their online academy through this online button. We have also put WhatsApp chat instead of the default chat box. Now let's see the online academy.
You can see the look and feel is again different. Though here the course pages are the default one. They only teach live classes, so it has got the live classes under the batches, and give only one downloadable file which is been put under the curriculum here.
Now you may ask, why do someone need to have an online academy if they are teaching only live? The answer is, unlike for independent Zoom and Google Meet classes, you need not to send their links to each learner and then count their attendance manually. You need to set a batch with a fixed time for the class, its name and the number of learners in it, and that's it. Your class learners will get the notifications in their mailboxes and they can log into the academy and enter the live class. For live classes, Zoom and Meet are fully embedded in the academy, and other third-party tools for live meetings and webinars can also be embedded on demand without any extra cost to you. So here at this demonstrative academy, I am logging as the admin because only an admin has the access to the backend where it can change the design of the academy. I am now going to the backend of this academy by clicking this manage button. Now in the backend, you have the learning content, academy, market and sell, users, account, help as the main menu items. In the academy, if you click, you will have
first customize submenu from where you can customize the main features of the academy.
Then the pages
from where you can build numerous number of pages in your online academy.
Then you can have the blog. From here you can put the blog post. And this is the setting. So coming to the first menu item, which is the customize, that is customize your academy. So in this page, you have the first tab as basic, then home page, then doing the banner, which would be obviously on the home page, and then the blocks. The blocks which are visible on the home page, then you can put the testimonials and then the social icons. So coming to the basic, in the basic you can name your academy. Here for this demonstrative academy we have named it as EduMaker and we have made this logo. So you can see we have the URL as edumaker.createonlineacademy.com. This is the first URL by which the academy will be made. Then obviously you can redirect it to your own URL. Also you can hook it to your own existing website. Everything is possible in this website as far as the URL goes. Then you can have the logo. We have this thing here on the left side. From here you can add the logo, then this you can add the favicon. This thing is the favicon. Then your tagline. Here we have given digital study for higher education. This is the tagline which is visible here. Then you can set the font, size of the font and the theme color. We have selected the black. So here you have the black one. Now, coming to the tab homepage. In the homepage, you will see about info block. Whether you have to show it or hide it, the option is there. This is the about info block. Actually, it's not a block, it's a page. All other blocks like best online academy, students community, finance facilities, all these are the names we have given and they can be changed. And online certification, e-learning industry, then study anytime, anywhere, student scholarship. These are just example blocks. They can be managed from this tab, name blocks.
As you can see, there are 8 published blocks on homepage.
So they are visible here. And these 2 are not published, so it is not green. You can create a new block from here, and from this page you can assign them the location. Okay, so all these blocks can be managed from this tab, but the about info is not a block, it's a page. it can be managed from the section of pages where there is a page called About Us. Now here we can see this block named About Creators University. Please note that it is the name given to the About Us page by us for the demonstration, and if you click the read more, it will lead to the About Us page. This is the page. Okay, obviously you can design it in any fashion. So here About Us, About Info block, whether you want to show or you want to hide, you can choose from here. Then the menu, if you have chosen it to be shown in the right or left, like here it can be seen on the right side because the menu is in the right. Then you, whether you want to show the search box or you want to hide, this is the search box where people can search for the courses.
Then next,
whether you want to show the course block or you want to hide it, this is the course block on the home page. The three courses are visible here.
As in this field named number of courses to display in the course block, we have put the figure of 3, and that's why 3 courses which can again be selected from here are displayed.
Then further, title of the course block,
which we have named as the popular courses, can be put. You may put them as per your preference in your own language.
Then whether you want to show the newsletter block, means it's a subscription for the newsletter. This is that thing. Whether you want to show it or you want to hide it, okay, you can choose it from here. Then title of the newsletter block, we have given it subscribe to our newsletter. You can put anything there, maybe in English, maybe in any other language, even you can use the Arabic. Then subtitle of the newsletter block, this was the title and this is the subtitle. Then do you want the testimonial to be on or to be off? If you want, this is the testimonial, this is a testimonial block. You can also shift it anywhere. What would be the title of that block? We have given it the same, testimonials. Okay. Then the blocks titles setting, these are the blocks titles. So this is the setting for them. What type of font you want to use? What should be the size? What should be the color? Then below this are the SEO settings, search engine optimization setting.
Under this, the first field is that of SEO title, where you need to enter the site's title, which will be displayed by the search engines. Then the next field is of SEO description, where you need to enter the description which should appear with the SEO title. And the last field is of keywords, which should be relevant to your courses, blogs and other page titles which you believe people will search and should land on this e-learning website of yours.
So after homepage, we go to the banner tab. Here you can either choose a static banner or a dynamic slider of multiple images appearing below the header in your home page. If you choose the banner option, then sign up box will appear by default on the right hand side of the image. In case you do not want to show sign up box, then choose the slider option and put 1 to 5 images. So this is the banner. Slider is hidden. If you choose the slider, then these options will come. You can add at the max 5 slides with your images and the heading text on them with a description. Down below, you can do settings for slider autoplay, interval in milliseconds, background image along with the color option for heading and description text. Then coming to the blocks which we had discussed earlier also, new blocks can be added or the existing one can be edited, and I am editing one of them. The title can be edited, the image can be edited, and the content written in it can be edited. And from this field, the position of the block can be decided. And then you need to press the update button. Then you can publish or unpublish it from here also. Now let me show you where is this block. Here it is at the bottom row, titled as Study Anytime Anywhere, with its image and text we have just seen. Then coming to the next step, that is the testimonial. From here you can edit or add new testimonials, and you can edit the title and text of the testimonials along with the image of the person providing it. And obviously you can publish or unpublish the testimonial from this checkbox. After this, coming to the last one is the social icon. You can turn it on and off and put the links of your Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn and YouTube accounts, which will appear in the footer like this, so that the academy visitors can also get connected to you on social media. We can put other social media icons too on your demand. Just remember, we are always with you to give any support without charging anything extra from you. Remember that this design is not the only option you have, and we can give you any design as per your wish in a bespoke manner. Now let us see how to create other pages in the online academy. Remember, you can have unlimited pages in this e-learning website of yours. So in the academy menu, clicking the submenu item named pages. By default you will find four pages here, namely contact us, about us, sample page and terms of use. You can unpublish and fully edit them and add new pages as well. While about us and contact us page will be in the main menu, all other newly created pages including terms of use will be in the submenu of more. In the terms of use page, we have given default terms of use where you have to put your academy name and domain name, and you need to review all these contents. Further, with this field, you may choose to keep this page listed under the more menu in the front end. If not, then you can use the page to link it to other pages or exclusively for the search engine optimization. And for that, with each page, you will find settings for search engine optimization, that is for title, description, and keywords. Let's once again see the editor of a new page or an aptly named sample page present by default. You will find a rich editor to make eye-catching pages. One can put text with options for formatting it along with the images, videos, links, mathematical equations, HTML, etc. Now these pages should be used optimally to boost your search engine ranking, for which the SEO fields can be used as been discussed earlier. And from time to time, you must update these fields for all the pages. Remember, you can have unlimited of such pages and can either put their links on the menu that would appear under the item of more, or you can keep it just linked to other pages or text content in the lectures, quiz or assignments. I mean to say that it all depends on your own creativity. Further, there are three default pages which you cannot delete but certainly unpublish from the front end. These pages are namely Contact Us, About Us, and Terms of Use. At last, let's see the Contact Us page, which by default appears in the main menu along with the About Us page, whose snippet can also be shown on the front page. Here you can put the text of the title and the description of the Contact Us page along with the address, phone number, email, website and Google Map code and save the changes. Now let's see the Contact Us page at the front end. At the top of the form fields, the text being put in the description is visible, and below the form you can see the location map along with the address, telephone, email and web link. Again, I would like to repeat that you are not confined to only this design template, and we can give you any design as been demanded by you without any extra cost, as this service is included in your plan package. So this sums up our pages section, and now we shall see the block section. By clicking the block menu here in the back end, we land on this page. You should add a new blog post every now and then and can add infinite number of posts in your blog section which has a link on the main menu. So here you can see a demonstrative blog, and coming to the back end, let's see how to add a new post in it. A blog post editor is similar to that for the pages. In the editor for the main body, you can add images, insert and edit videos, insert links and mathematical equations. You can also format the text, insert tables, and put the HTML. Similarly, there are fields to optimize the page for search engine ranking, that are for the SEO title, description and keywords. And needless to say that you need to visit and edit these fields from time to time to enhance and maintain the blog's ranking in the generic searches. Now we shall see the menu of settings. From this page, you can do the general settings of your online academy, settings for payments, subscription plan, certificate, social logins, email, and for the custom domain. Let's now see the fields under the general settings. First is the field of currency, in which your courses are to be priced. Then your time zone setting, date format, and hour format setting, meaning if the displayed clock is to be a 12-hour clock or a 24-hour clock. At last is the field of the setting, if you want to allow the breadcrumbs to be displayed in the pages or not. And by default, it is set as yes. Now, if you want to know what is breadcrumb, press this link and you will find a detailed idea about that. However, let me show you what is the breadcrumb in a page. The breadcrumb is displayed usually on the pages, and it shows the route to that from the home page. Like this is a breadcrumb, and here on this page is breadcrumb. It is not just useful for visitors to navigate your e-learning website, but is a must for search engine optimization, to help a search engine index your website and then enhance your rankings in the search results. And you should always let it be set as yes. Now, coming to the settings of payment. Here we have Stripe and Razorpay as the payment processing software integrated by default.
And we can integrate any other payment app or gateway on your specific demand without any extra cost to you.
Stripe works internationally and is a very popular software to accept and send payments, while Razorpay is India-centric. Nevertheless, we can integrate any other payment software on demand like PayPal, Amazon Pay, Square in a very quick time. And when you click a payment software of choice, its field for the keys will also be available,
which you need to fill.
To make the payment processing software active in your e-learning website, so that you can take the payments from your learners in view of the online courses and other services. Now say that you do not know how to find these keys, we are always there to help you out and rather would do that for you. You can count on us anytime for everything.
Next is the setting of subscription plans. This is meant for those courses which are having limited time access for their learners. And these time periods are called subscription plans, which can be set from this page. You can give these plans a name and a time period in days, months, or years. Further, you can edit, unpublish, or delete the existing plans. Next is the tab for settings of the certificate. Here you can design the course certificates, while the conditions to be fulfilled by the learners to get the certificate can be set from the settings page of the course itself. So, to design the certificate, you can choose either from a pre-made theme and background, or you can upload your own design. Then, choose the text color and fonts for the certificate. Further, you can design the certificate content with the available variables like student first name, student last name, completion date, etc., which are listed here on this table. Down below, you can put the text content to be displayed in the certificate page of the learner. Your learner will have a page of certificate where all the certificates awarded from your online academy will be stored. And there, for each certificate, there is a separate page. And for each such page, you can put this text above the certificate, which the learner can also download. And then in the last field, you can design the content of the mail to be sent to your learners once their certificate is approved. Needless to say, all the text can have the variables which you can find in the table above. After the certificate settings, we will see the tab for social logins. Social login is the functionality that let your visitors log into your online academy through their social media accounts like Facebook and Google. So in this tab, the button for social login has to be switched on. Down below, if you want to start social login for Facebook, you have to put the app ID and secret key of the same, and similarly for the Google. You can get these keys from your accounts on this social media. Though it is straightforward to find them, you may Google how to do that. Otherwise, contact us and we will help you out like always. Similarly, we can add this functionality for other social media like LinkedIn and others on your request. Now let's see the tab of email settings. As evident, your online academy sends several automated emails to your students like welcome mail, and from here you can change the sender's name and email signature in those automated emails. However, this field of from email can't be changed and it will remain default to your admin login email. But if you want to change that, let us know and we can do that from our systems database. After email setting, let's see the tab of custom domain. This tab is only a guideline for pointing your domain name to this online academy, which currently has the subdomain of the createonlineacademy.com. You actually need to change the records in the domain name server of your purchase domain name, for which the instructions are provided here. It's a bit technical thing, but you just let us know your intention for this and we shall help you out.